Dear learners, welcome to Certificate in Arabic Language online lectures. I am Dr. Muhammad Saleem, Assistant Professor, Arabic School of Foreign Languages, Indira Gandhi National Open University. Dear learners, in these lectures, we are helping you to communicate in Arabic. And we have given you plenty of commonly used Arabic expressions. Now in this lecture, I will give you certain Arabic expressions. Some of them might be looking like words, but they are sentences. And with the help of those, you can communicate. So dear learners, the first one that I will discuss with you is udkhul. 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 What is udkhul? Udkhul means enter. Okay? If somebody is knocking the door and you want him or her to come in, so you say udkhul. Udkhul. Sometimes you say udkhul fil bayt. Udkhul fil bayt or udkhul fil ghurfa. It's a little bit long sentence. Udkhul fil bayt. Udkhul means enter. Fi means in. And al-bayt is house. So udkhul fil bayt means enter the house. Come inside the house. Okay. So udkhul. Udkhul. It's a verb and you are commanding somebody. Okay. You are saying someone udkhul. Okay. Enter. Enter. Udkhul fil bayt. Dakhala. Root word is dal khala. Dakhala. Dakhala yadkhul means to enter. Dakhala. From that root word dakhala, dakhala, dakhala is fi'l madhi and udkhul is fi'l amr. Udkhul, udkhul, okay, command, udkhul. So you enter, enter, and you say udkhul fi'l bayt, udkhul fi'l madrasa, udkhul fi'l maktab, udkhul fi'l maktaba. Means you can form as many sentences as possible, because udkhul you have got it, okay, and now fi'l bayt, fi'l madrasa, fi'l matar. Matar means airport. Fil mustashfa means hospital. Fil fishari' means road. Udkhul, udkhul. Okay, so you have got this word, and with the help of this, you can expand it and make useful sentences. And udkhul, by the way, itself happens to be a sentence. It's not a word. Okay, the beauty of Arabic is that it can, you know, aap ghar mein dakhil ho jayein. What you say in Urdu or Hindi, aap ghar ke andar aayein. Aap andar aayein, okay? In Arabic we say udkhul, udkhul, that's all. Udkhul means andar aayein, all right? And now the next one, just opposite to that, okay, is ukhruj. 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 What does this mean? Ukhruj, just opposite. Ukhruj means get out, go out, get out, okay? Ukhruj. Kharaja. Root word is kha, ra, jim, kharaja, ya khruju means to go out, yeah, to get out. So ukhruj means you get out, get out. If you want somebody to go out of the room and you are saying ukhruj, that's all, ukhruj. And you can also use ukhruj min al bayt. Ukhruj min al bayt, it means get out of this house. Ukhruj min al ghurfa means get out from this room. Okay, so ukhruj, ukhruj, ukhruj means somebody, if you want somebody to go out, so you will use this word ukhruj. Ukhruj, it is also a complete sentence, all right? Ukhruj, root word as I told you earlier is kharaja. Kharaja. Kha, ra, jim. Kharaja. Kharaja yakhruju. Kharaja yakhruju. Okay. Means to go out. So you have learned to dakhala, two words. Dakhala. And these are verbs, you know. And they give, you know, they are like sentences. Okay. So dakhala kharaja. Dakhala, from dakhala you got udkhul. From kharaja you got اخرج from دخل ادخل from خرج اخرج now ذهب 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 يذهب ذهب يذهب what does it mean what does it mean ذهب ذهب means to go ذهب means to go اذهب اذهب means you go you are commanding somebody you know you're asking somebody to go so ذهب يذهب to go and اذهب go means you go اذهب you go all right so this way you can اذهب where to go اذهب الى السوق means go to the market if you are asking somebody you are saying if you want to say go to the market so the best expression means right expression in Arabic is اذهب الى السوق اذهب الى السوق and if you want somebody to go to the school so what you will say on the same pattern اذهب الى المدرسة go to the school okay اذهب الى المستشفى means go to the hospital اذهب الى المطار means go to the airport okay اذهب الى المدينة means go to the city اذهب الى القرية go to the village all right so this way you have got one important Arabic verb and with the help of this very common Arabic verb you can form your own sentence and you can use it wherever you want it's up to you all right I am just giving you one clue and with the help of this you can communicate very effectively in Arabic language dear learners the next Arabic word that I am going to give you is توقف توقف okay توقف what does it mean توقف 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 what is توقف توقف means stop means somebody is speaking and you want him or her to stop you will say توقف or for means anybody who is going just running or walking and you want the person to say stop so in Arabic you will say توقف 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 okay now another word suppose if you want to say somebody stay so what is stay in Arabic is ابقى 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 okay ابقى if you want to add something ابقى يا اخي okay stay my brother ابقى يا اخي ابقى يا اخي stay oh my brother or ابقى يا صديقي just stay on oh my friend okay so this way you can form little bit longer sentence okay now the next one is irhal irhal what is irhal irhal rahla okay rahla irhal rahla means to depart okay in Arabic ri ra ha la rahla rahla yarhal is to depart okay if you want somebody if you ask somebody to leave you know you say irhal irhal what does this mean it means leave irhal means leave means leave the place okay irhal anni sometimes you use irhal anni okay leave from here just go okay so irhal and the next one is taal taal huna taal huna what is this taal huna taal if I remember correctly you have learned this word taal all this expression taal means come taal huna come here suppose your friend is far from you and you want presence of your friend before you okay and you want to talk to him or her you are saying taal huna means come here okay taali okay if the person happens to be female a lady and you want her to come to you and talk to you so you will say taali huna taali huna taali huna all right now moving on to the next one اذهب هناك What is this? Idhab hunaka, idhab. Dhahaba, yadhhabu. This is very commonly used Arabic verb. Dhahaba means to go. Dhahaba, yadhhabu. Okay, dhahaba, yadhhabu. From that, dhahaba, dhal, ha. Then add ha. Always remember not ha. This is ha, ha. Dhahaba, yadhhabu, yadhhabu. From that, you have got idhab. Idhab means go. Go, as if you are commanding somebody to go. Okay, idhab. So, idhab hunaka. Idhab hunaka. Idhab hunaka. What does it mean? Go there. Go there. Okay, huna, hunaka. What is the difference between huna and hunaka? Huna, huna means here, and hunaka means there. Okay, okay. So, ta'al huna. تعال هنا come here and اذهب هناك go there okay so it's you know هنا and هناك I think you have got the difference between the two تعال هنا تعال هنا or تعالي هنا اذهب هناك اذهب هناك so if the person happens to be a female lady she you will say to her اذهبي اذهبي هناك Same way, the way you use تعالي هنا so اذهبي هناك go there for female in English we do not differentiate between that okay there is no difference between gender with this gender go go for both go go there come here go there both for male and female for ladies Indian both same here difference okay اذهب for male and اذهبي for female okay so now moving on to the next expression And that is really, really, you know, very, very important and exciting to learn. So you'll say, Matya hun nafsak. What is this? Matya. 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 Say, Ain, Ain, Ain. Matya. Nafsaka. Matya nafsaka. What does that mean? Matya nafsaka. Enjoy yourself. Al muta. Al muta is enjoyment, okay? Al muta. Mim ta, Ain. Matya. Matya. نفسك متع نفسك what does this mean متع نفسك enjoy yourself متع نفسك enjoy yourself okay enjoy yourself it's so common you know we always ask we say to our friends oh go and enjoy yourself okay you need not worry about much about anything okay اذهب ومتع نفسك means go and enjoy yourself اذهب ومتع نفسك go and enjoy yourself okay so متع نفسك this is the expression okay and pronunciation متع always say this متع نفسك not نفسك نفسك okay and again متعي نفسك okay in case of female you can say متعي okay متعي نفسك all right now again moving to the next one And the expression is equally important. You use it everyday life situation, and it's very good. Ibqa, ibqa hadin. Ibqa hadin. What does this mean? Ibqa, ibqa hadin. Ibqa. Baqiya yabqa means to remain, remain. Baqiya, baqi. We say na baqi. Paisa baqi hai. Okay. It's Arabic. From Arabic, baqiya. Baqiya means baqiya. Whatever remains, that is baqiya. Baqiya yabqa. Ba, qaf ya baqiya. From that, fi'l amr. Ibqa. And next one is hadin. Hadin, ibqa hadin. What is the meaning? Ibqa hadin. Be quiet. Ibqa hadin. Ibqa, but qaf. I am not saying kaf. No. Ibqa. Ibqa hadin. Hadin. It's not ha. No. Hadin. 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 Ibqa hadin means be quiet. Okay. Be quiet. So this expression, dear learners, I think you are. Not only learning it, but also at the same time enjoying it. Okay. Next one is ساعد. ساعد نفسك. ساعد نفسك. What is ساعد? ساعد. ساعد يساعد. سين عين دال. Root word is سين عين دال. مساعدة is help. Okay. ساعد نفسك. ساعد نفسك means help yourself. Wow. Good expression. We use it, you know, so often in English. Help yourself, and in Arabic it is ساعد نفسك ساعد nafsaka, help yourself. Alright? And for female, it's slight, you know, different, just like earlier, you know, sentences and expressions you have seen. You'll find sa'idi, sa'idi nafsaki. Okay? A little difference, you know, here. Sa'idi nafsaki. Sa'id nafsaka. Okay? And sa'idi nafsaki for female. Okay? So, and the meaning remains same. Help yourself. Help yourself. Okay? Next one is, and is equally important, idhab ala tool. What does this mean? Idhab ala tool. Idhab, you know, I think. Dhahaba idhab. Idhab, you go. Okay? Ala tool. Okay, it happens in most of the time that you are in your place, your village, your city, or your residence, around your residence, and someone who is just, you know, passing by and wants to know the address of a particular place. So what do? You just guide him or her, okay? And then you say, go straight, turn right, turn left, okay? All this way you explain. So how would you explain all that in Arabic? Okay, I am just explaining to you, okay? Don't worry, you will get it, all right? So the expression is, if somebody is asking you and you want to say go straight, okay? The person might be walking, maybe, you know, having a car, and but expression will remain same. If you want to tell the person go straight, then in Arabic you will say idhab ala tul. Okay, idhab ala tul. Tul means lamba, okay? Tul is long, lamba. In Arabic we say lamba. Tul. So tul means straight, means you need not turn here and there, left, right, okay, all that you need not do that. You just keep on going straight way. Don't turn here and there. Just so, idhab ala tul. Idhab ala tul. This is the expression. Idhab ala tul. All right. This is real learner. I think increasingly becoming exciting for you to learn because it will help you a lot, and you should do it. You go. Idhab ala tul. It's one. Next one is in atif yaminan. Okay. If you want to tell the person, turn right. So you will say in atif ta. It's not ta. In atif yaminan. In atif yaminan means turn right. And if you want to say turn left, then in atif yasaran. In atif yasaran. So in atif yaminan, in atif yasaran. These are, you know, Arabic. Idhab ala tul, you have learned it. In atif yaminan, in atif yasaran. Okay, this is how you explain to the person who is looking for the address. Okay, so I hope that with these expressions, wonderful Arabic expressions, you will be fully capable of guiding somebody who has lost his or her way, okay? So you will be able to help him or her reach his or her destination, okay? So again, remember, idhab ala tul, in atif yaminan, in atif yasaran, okay? Now, just dear learners, now I wish you could practice and practice more and more. And for that purpose, I have just picked up, you know, some more important Arabic, you know, verbs, most of them from fa'il amr, so that you can, you know, concentrate on it, focus on it, and be able to learn it, because same thing we have discussed earlier, okay? So, but I will just say Arabic one, you have to say in English, okay? What does it mean? I will not explain it in English, so that you yourself can stand on your leg. I will not support you always, okay? You have to rely on yourself. اعتمد على نفسك. You have learned rely on yourself. This expression you have learned. So here also rely on yourself. اعتمد على نفسك. Okay. So I'm giving just the Arabic expression, and you have to find the meaning. So the verb is ادخل. Khul. Okay, see the meaning? Udkhul. Go back to the earlier, you know, expressions. If you're not able to guess, then you can search and then okay, memorize. Udkhul. Ukhruj. Ukhruj. Next one is idhab. Idhab. Say the way I am saying, okay? Idhab, follow me, okay? Idhab. 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 Dhal, dhal, dhal. Idhab. Next one is tawakkaf. Tawakkaf. Qaf. This is not kaf. Tawakkaf, no. Tawakkaf. Tawakkaf. And by the way, in case of female, okay, you can change udkhul from udkhul to udkhuli, from ukhruj to ukhruji, idhab, idhabi, tawakkaf, tawakkafi. Okay, it will keep on changing accordingly. Okay, I am not explaining much grammar here, but just now, since it is really, you know, indispensable, I have to tell you, so I'm telling this, okay? Tawakkaf, because you don't know, you might be talking to a male or a female, okay, anyway. So, tawakkaf, tawakkafi, alright? Ibqa, ibqa, ibqa for male, ibqi, ibqi, ibqi ala hal, okay, ibqi, alright? Now, next, irhal, 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 and for female, irhali, what do you say? Irhali, irhali. And next one is ta'al, ta'ain, okay, ta'al, 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 for male and for female, ta'ali, 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 ta'ali ya sadiqi, ta'ali ya sadiqati, ta'ali ya sadiqi, ta'ali ya sadiqati, okay? So this way you can practice. Now, ta'ali, ta'al huna, or ta'ali huna. Okay, both for you. Male for male and female, both. For both you can. Okay. Different way. Ta'al for male, ta'al huna, ta'ali huna for female. Then, idhab hunaka, hunaka, hunaka. It's far from you, okay? You want somebody to go there. So you are saying, idhab hunaka. Or for female, idhabi hunaka. Okay? Next one is, matti'a nafsaka, matti'a nafsaka. This I have discussed, I promised, I have told you that I will not any repeat it so that you will become, you will relax and say, okay, I have just getting it easily. So, no, you have to work hard. Matti'a nafsaka, matti'a nafsaka, and matti'i nafsaka. Nafsaki, ki, not ka, okay? Matti'i nafsaki, okay? Ibqa hadiyan, ibqi hadiyatan. Okay, this way. Expression will change as per, okay, if the person happens to be the female, ibqa hadiyan for male, ibqi hadiyatan for female, okay. Sa'id nafsaka, similarly, sa'id nafsaka, help yourself. Sa'idi nafsaki, okay. Now, the next one is, idhab ala tool, idhab ala tool. Okay, when you are telling somebody the, you know, direction, you are saying, go straight, idhab ala tool. And for female, idhabi ala tool. If you are saying, turn right, in atif yameenan, and left, in atif yasaran. Okay, so in atifi yameenan for female, in atifi yasaran for female. In atifi yameenan for female, and in atifi yasaran again for female. Okay. In atif becomes in atifi, okay, this is how it changes, okay, according to the gender. So dear learners, I hope with the help of these, you know, expressions and the way I am explaining to you, you are able to not only learn but enjoy it, because it's not very difficult, in fact, if you can focus on learning and you are really, you know, ready to have many Arabic expressions. Now I am going to help you practice more, and this time I will give you English, you know, some English words and even sentences, small expressions. You have to find the meaning, you know, Arabic. I will not, again, I'm telling you, I will not help you much. You have to find the meaning. And I am saying enter. First one is enter. Next one is get out. Third is go. Fourth is help yourself. Okay. Next is go straight. Next one is turn right. Next one is turn left. Next one is be quiet. And again, one is come here. Okay. So, dear learners, you see, these are English, you know, and all these we have discussed earlier, so I will not repeat it. You just try to you know, check your progress, and are you able to make it, are you able to learn it, are you able to find the meaning? It's up to you to find. Okay, so if you are not, then again go back to the initial stage, and there you will find the meaning of all of this. So don't worry, don't stretch yourself, don't be stressful, just enjoy. Okay, and I wish you can learn by enjoying, you can enjoy by learning this. Okay, all right. And then now I am coming to the next stage, and that is the third practice. And what is this? How do I have just informed a small para based on whatever expressions you have learned, and on the basis of that I will just, you know, tell you all these expressions, you will repeat and internalize these, okay, accordingly. So I am saying Ya akhi Ammar. Okay, I have just added, you know, some one or two words here and there, so don't be, you know, much scared that it is little difficult and overloaded. No, and it is just, it's very simple. I have just, for the sake of, you know, formation of sentence, I have done it. Ya akhi ammar. This is one sentence. Okay, ya akhi ammar. And next one, udkhul fil bayt. You are saying to your brother Ammar to enter to the house. Okay, so you are saying ya akhi ammar udkhul. Again, you are using the word udkhul, fi'l amr, udkhul fil bayt. And watawaqqaf. Again, this one I have used earlier. Watawaqqaf. This is qaf, not kaf. Tawaqqaf. Ya akhi Ammar. I will be a little bit slow so that you can grasp it properly. Ya akhi Ammar. Ammar. This is not Ammar. No. No. Ayn. Again, Ayn. You have done a lot of practice of Ayn. Okay. You have got many words starting from Ayn. Okay. So I think you can it. You can do it. Ya akhi Ammar. Ya akhi Ammar. Udkhul. Udkhul fil bayt. Okay. Ya akhi Ammar. Udkhul fil bayt. Wa tawaqqaf. Wa dhahab ila as-souq. Wa tawaqqaf. Wa dhahab ila as-souq. Ila as-souq. Souq. Qaf. Again, it's not kaf, it is qaf. وتوقف واذهب الى السوق ومتع نفسك. I am repeating several times so that you can be quite familiar with these expressions. Again, I am saying يا أخي عمار ادخل في البيت وتوقف. Then I am saying واذهب الى السوق ومتع نفسك. Matih nafsak. Okay. Now, again, I am moving. Ash-shari'u wasih. Ash-shari'u wasih. What is shari'? Ash-shari' is road. Wasih is wide. Okay. This one might be a little, you know, this is something that I have not used there. So I am explaining to you. Ash-shari'. What is shari' in Arabic? Shari' is road. Okay. Wasih is wide. الشارع واسع. الشارع واسع. Or you can say الشارع واسع. Okay, this one is standard. الشارع واسع. But while when we speak, we do not use tanween all that. الشارع واسع. Okay. Now the next one is اذهب على طول. Okay. I'm giving the direction. الشارع واسع. اذهب الى السوق ومتع نفسك. I'm then again saying الشارع واسع. اذهب على طول. على طول. This is not ta. طو. And على. So again. اذهب على طول. وبعد ذلك. بعين دال. عين. بعد. وبعد ذلك. إن عطف إن عين طوفة إن عطف يمينا يمينا إن عطف يمينا إن عطف يمينا okay إن عطف يمينا I guess you understand what I'm saying in fact because these expressions you have practiced so there should be no difficulty at all in understanding what I am conveying to you okay so بعد ذلك إن عطف يمينا وبعد ذلك إن عطف يمينا وبعد ذلك إن عطف يسارا وبعد ذلك إن عطف يسارا okay then وبقى هاديا 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 means calm and quiet you know and the word is you know word sounds like this you know هاديا هاديا you see how the word is matching the sound you know هاديا هاديا as if something very soft delicate very peaceful you know هاديا eh? so وبقى وبقى قاف with وبقى هاديا 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 be quiet okay be quiet be quiet okay and the next one وساعد وساعد نفسك وساعد نفسك وساعد نفسك okay so this small para the objective is to just help you repeat the same thing in different way and learn Arabic expressions through this okay so I am just going to once again repeat just say the same thing try to follow me the way I am speaking you should also speak okay so again once more يا أخي أمار ادخل في البيت وتوقف واذهب إلى السوق ومتع نفسك الشارع واسع الشارع واسع okay اذهب على طول straight okay اذهب على طول وبعد ذلك إن عطف يمينا وبعد ذلك إن عطف يسارا وبقى هاديا وساعد نفسك so dear learners these wonderful Arabic expressions are helping you to communicate easily in everyday life situations okay it's up to you how you are going to practice it you will if you practice it certainly you will learn the language learn how to communicate in ordinary life situations these are the word expressions which are frequently used by everybody everywhere okay so by grasping all these by internalizing all these expressions you are certainly making a lot of progress and that will encourage you to move towards further learning so dear learners my best wishes for your learning and مع السلامة إلى اللقاء قريبا bye bye